Hi, I'm Rhett with testingtheory.com, and today we're going to talk about the importance of quantifying your qualitative data and also how the wrong type of quantitative data can really hurt your testing efforts. I'm going to show you a real example that just happened to be recently and how some qualitative data was twisted to try and get something that wasn't true, and how in this example, someone used quantitative data to justify their position without telling the full story behind that quantitative data. Just recently, I worked with a client that ran a very high-profile test. It was in the navigation, it was a global test, and had a lot of eyes on it, a lot of people saw it, and honestly, there were some in the company that didn't like it. After the test had been running for a while, we got an email from someone in the company that didn't like the test. This person was over the qualitative feedback for the company, and so he saw the responses that people were sending in when they were confused or had feedback for the site. With regards to our test, this person who was getting the feedback said, "Lots of people are confused by this. I've had lots of feedback coming in, and I'm anxious to see this test turned off." After receiving this email, and knowing that we actually do want to have qualitative feedback in any good test, qualitative and quantitative, I responded to this person with a simple request. I said, "Can you please help us know the number of people you've helped who are confused, and also can you send us their feedback so we can see it, so that we can include it in our final report on this test?" So this is an important factor. When someone is complaining about a test or saying there's a lot of problems with it, they're giving that qualitative measure of what they think and what they perceive other people are thinking. I wanted to quantify that qualitative feedback by asking for the number of people who felt that way. So the response that I got back from this person was that there was 1 to 2 people who were experiencing this problem every day. Well, this person also mentioned that even though 1 to 2 people were experiencing it, those 1 to 2 people mentioned they knew other people who were experiencing the problem. So when I pressed this person to quantify this qualitative feedback, it was 1 to 2 people per day, plus a few other people that those 1 to 2 people know. On the surface, if we didn't quantify the qualitative feedback, we might be left thinking, wow, a lot of people don't like this. And that's the message that this person was sending in this massive group email they started, saying, "I'm really anxious to turn this off because lots of people are having a problem with this." So in this case, the test had only been running for about 7 days. So on the high end, we might have 14 to maybe 30 to 40 people who entered the test, who were not happy with the test, who wrote feedback about it. To further give his position weight, the client had access to some data. And so he went in and looked at some search data and found that previously about 400 people had been searching for a keyword that was part of this test. Once the test had launched, that search result had lifted to about 800 to 1100 people searching for that thing, presumably because they couldn't find it and they were searching for it because this test had impacted their experience. So when I pressed him to quantify his qualitative feedback, he came back and said 1 to 2 people. Then he tried to quantify his position by having some extra analytics data that supported what he wanted. In this case, he presented his quantitative data to show that there's an extra 400 people per the test time period who are negatively impacted by this, and that's why they're searching for it. Again, on the surface, this might seem like a big deal. And if you are relying on qualitative data or the wrong quantitative data, you might be prone to make a mistake, to react prematurely and turn off a test or change things or do something drastic. And this is human, this is natural. When we feel and experience something firsthand, when we have a bad experience, we want to tell someone. If someone has a bad experience, we feel the empathy of that because we relate to that because it's human. And so sometimes as testers or in organizations, when there's qualitative feedback that is bad, especially if it can be quantified, it's normal and natural to want to see people in a company that will want to turn off a test or make a change or stop what's happening. However, there was one important piece of quantitative data that was not part of what this person was talking about, and that was the fact that 5.4 million people had entered this test. So when you run the numbers and you figure out of 5.4 million people, we've had 14 to 30 people write us feedback, hey, that's not too bad. And in that same light, when you see that there's an additional 400 searches coming that may indicate that this is a bad experience, when you compare that to 5.4 million people of those 400 searches, that means that those 400 searches are 0.00% of all visitor traffic. So is this a big deal? No, it's not. The wrong quantitative data could be misleading, just like a little bit of qualitative data can be misleading. As good experience optimizers, we have to be very careful, and we need to quantify the qualitative data that people give us. We also need to be careful, and we need to use the right quantitative data when other people give it to us as well. As optimizers, we needed to be able to tell the full story. And some people will have access to quantitative data, but it doesn't tell the full story. We needed to be able to say exactly what happened with the full picture of quantitative data. By putting things into perspective, by quantifying the qualitative, and understanding the best quantitative data out there, you can help people make good decisions. So in summary, there's a few takeaways. Number one is to always quantify your qualitative data to make sure that you're not making decisions based on just a small percent or small sample size of qualitative data. Recommendation number two, make sure that you're using the full data set available to you, and you need to be very cautious of people who are telling a story based on a small slice of quantitative data. And finally, one of the most important recommendations I can give you is when someone is antagonistic towards your testing and is trying to shut down a test or shut down what you're doing, use data the right way. Use logic. Be persuasive in a way that is building and not trying to tear people down based on opinion. Use data in a way that helps show your case. Thanks for joining me today. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please hit the like button. Give me that thumbs up.